Hi, my name is Sohaib Katariwala, and I am an analytics specialist at AWS. In this demo, I will show you how you can get started with Amazon Redshift Serverless. From the AWS console, I'll navigate to Amazon Redshift. From the Amazon Redshift landing page, I'll click on Try Amazon Redshift Serverless. This brings us to the simple configuration page where you can pick the settings for Redshift Serverless. You can choose to use default settings or customize the settings for your specific needs. I'll choose Use Default Settings and Save Configuration. In just a few minutes, Redshift will create my serverless endpoint. And just like that, I was easily able to create Amazon Redshift Serverless without having to specify any capacity with just a couple of clicks. On the Redshift Serverless dashboard, I can see a default workgroup and namespace is created and available for use in my account. Now that our serverless endpoint is ready, let's start querying some data. I'll click on Query Data to launch Amazon Redshift Query Editor version 2. On the list of Redshift resources, you'll see serverless followed by the name of your serverless workgroup. In this case, my workgroup is called Default. I'll click on that and connect using temporary credentials. Under my serverless default workgroup, I see a dev database and a sample data dev database. Let's expand sample data dev. Under that, we see placeholders for three schemas corresponding to three datasets that we can load into our Amazon Redshift database using a single click. I'll click on the ticket schema to initiate creation of the sample data dev database, the ticket schema, the sample tables under ticket schema, and to load ticket sales data into those sample tables. It will also provide us with some queries to run against the sample data. Once the sample data is loaded, you can view the table details in the object browser and run the sample queries such as top events by sales price and top buyers by quantity sold. Amazon Redshift Serverless will respond to my workload needs and scale up and down as needed. While we are using Query Editor version 2, I also want to point out that it has a rich set of features to help you manage and run your SQL statements for data exploration, ad hoc queries, and for querying your data lake. Above the list of Amazon Redshift resources that I can connect to, I can click on Load Data to load data from Amazon S3 into an Amazon Redshift table. I can also click on the Create drop-down button to create a database, a schema, a table, or a function in Amazon Redshift. When I click on Create Schema, I have the option to create a local schema in the Redshift database that I'm currently connected to. Or I can create an external schema from the Glue data catalog that represents databases in my Amazon S3 based data lake, which will allow you to query your data lake without having to load any data into Amazon Redshift Serverless. I can also create an external schema from an RDS Postgres or MySQL database to allow federated queries to my operational data stores directly from Amazon Redshift Serverless. Now, you have seen how quickly and easily you can get started with Redshift Serverless. Thank you for watching.